I'd like to close out the strategy portion of the Vegan Interactions Academy with an emphasis on self-care.
Help them relax. Hopefully they are just in bliss.
In reality, it doesn't matter how good communicators we are if we're not taking care of ourselves. I like to think of it like we each have our own vegan battery. Now these batteries can be charged up by positive experiences or drained by negative experiences. In 2017, Gary Yourofsky came out and said, "My tank is completely empty, so I will no longer be online or active in any capacity." Now anyone who knows Gary knows this is not due to lack of passion. That's why it's important for us to all be aware of our vegan batteries and how to keep them charged up. There's a few strategies I like to use to manage negative influences in my life. The first is to unplug from social media and unfollow those who share graphic content. I also limit my exposure to non-vegan food in situations where it's either unnecessary or where I feel it might be too much for me. Two examples in which I do this is I do online grocery ordering so I can avoid certain aisles at the grocery store. I've also stopped going to barbecues because I find that seeing animals used in that way is a bit too visceral for me. Now, one of the most important lessons I've learned is that we create our own social worlds. By surrounding ourselves with positive, emotionally healthy people, we're more likely to be positive and emotionally healthy ourselves. Don't forget to talk to people about what you're experiencing. You can share what upsets you, perhaps in a way that's not going to upset them. And if there's no signs of improvement, perhaps you can consult a professional, preferably one that's vegan friendly. The most important thing is to remember you're not alone. The feelings and things you're experiencing, chances are there's loads of other people out there experiencing the exact same things or very similar. So don't forget to reach out to others. A few of the ways I like to surround myself with positives are by going to vegan festivals, going to vegan outreach events where I'm likely to meet other like-minded people, giving myself some laugh therapy, for instance, going to the Vegan Humor Facebook page, going on holiday, preferably device-free, and going to animal sanctuaries because animals always recharge my batteries. There's also things I can do in my daily routine that help. For instance, getting good sleep, meditating, eating healthily and exercising, taking breaks, and allowing ourselves to process our feelings. If we're upset by something, there's probably a good reason for this. I like to think of this as a pressurized drink that if you take the cap off all at once, it's likely to explode all over the place. However, if we release the pressure gradually, it's likely to be much more manageable. I find all of this is reinforced by empowering self-talk. Saying to myself what bothers me and saying it's okay. The trick is to find what recharges our batteries and to make time for it daily. If we wait until the end of the week or the end of the month, it might be a bit late. Remember, the animals don't need our help today, tomorrow, or next week. They need our help this year, next year, and the following years. So let's do what we can to keep ourselves sustainable. So what recharges your vegan batteries? Let us know in the comments below. Thank you for joining me for the Vegan Interactions Academy. If you've now completed the psychology and the strategy sections, you can consider yourself a graduate.
Graduates, you are all destined for greatness. Each and every one of you has the potential to change the world.
In closing, don't let perfection be the enemy of progress. Just go out there, get started, and I think you'll be pleasantly surprised by how staying calm and applying the techniques we've discussed will lead to positive interactions. My goal with these videos is to provide a foundation to build upon. We're all continuing to evolve. I know I am. So I look forward to doing more videos like this and more street interviews in the future on any concepts and strategies as they come up. So what do you think? Do you think there are any tips or strategies that you could see applying to your own life? Perhaps there's a topic I missed that you'd like me to make a video about. Let us know in the comments below. Thank you so much for your support, and I'll see you on the streets. Encountering those myths or justifications? At this stage, our focus should be on countering those common myths or justifications. It's probably open to... I don't want to get it open. I can edit over it, can't I? That around 30 days... Axe that part, we'll put it in the... If they say yes, If they say yes, then they... I've done that a couple times, haven't I? Have you ever felt shame in your life? Did it make you feel good? Did it want to make you... I find that by avoiding the use of trigger words, after all, we are in my experience, it's best to praise those positive steps. I hope we're gonna be diluting our message, and we're gonna be able to say, okay. When you first go vegan, in order to find your much more likely to listen to what I have to say. One trick I use like to use, and try not saying yes but rather say, and that you're given daily recipe idea. I've done this like 1,000 times, I can't remember. And you're given daily recipe ideas and challenges, and you're supported by them. I can definitely do this in one go. I'm gonna do this until I get in one go. And would you like to sign up today? Both challenge 22 plus. La 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 la. La 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 la. Say something that upsets someone or show. The last tip I last. Perhaps you can consult a professional. Professional. I still don't figure out how to say it. I'm not gonna get this in one go, isn't I? Whereas if you replete. I hope you've had as much fun watching these videos as. They may not be. I think that's good.